Yeah, exactly. You know, it's pretty neat. You know, like I said, I think it's something I'll cherish a little bit longer down the line. But, you know, right now it's a pretty cool thing. I never would have thought it would happen.
As you look back on your high school career, what stands out the most for you during your time at Ada?
You know, just all the friends that I made, pretty much. You know, I still have, you know, lifelong friends that I still hang out with today. You know, all the stuff that we did together, just, you know, athletically and just, you know, friendship-wise. Just, you know, stuff that I'll never forget.
As you move forward now, big step with Miami, obviously a chance that you'd be reunited with Coach Gase. I suppose that's got to get you excited as well.
Oh, definitely. You know, me and Coach Gase, you know, made a great connection right from when we first met. And, you know, it's great to be able to play under him again, especially, you know, his first head coaching job.
What are your thoughts as you watch the Broncos play next week?
You know, they're looking pretty good right now. You know, I wish them, you know, nothing but the best. You know, hopefully they can bring it home this time for Peyton.
When I came to Ada 10 years ago, I walked into Ada and I went to Northern on Main. And I was with my wife Lisa, and I was just getting ready to take the job. And I looked down on the newspaper, and there was a picture of Zach playing basketball. And I go, hey, Lisa, that's the quarterback right there. That's the guy right there. And this woman behind me goes, that's my son. The first person I met in Ada was Carla Dyson. All right. So then Heather was like a step behind, and my wife's waiting on me at the table. 25 minutes later, I walked through the table and I go, she told me that I would love coaching her son, he'd love to play for you, and congratulations on the job. I don't have a job yet. She goes, oh, you will? It's going to be great. And I go, she's very right. We miss her dearly, Carla Dyson, a wonderful lady, Greg Dyson, Brooke Dyson, Heather Dyson. Coach Trax was right. When I, after the first day of football camp, I came back and told my wife, I said, I've got two Division I kids, and I said, Zach can be an NFL player. And I told people that for a long time. Now, I got three parts to tell you. One is what a great athlete he is that's not related to football. Because I've seen him bowl left-handed without putting his fingers in the thing, a 190 game, all right? I've seen him, you know, we played tennis, this is all our first period gym class. They had the district champion was over at Northern playing, and we went over there every morning, and I said, hey, you want some competition? And he goes, well, I won the district, and I go, well, this guy will be all right. Zach would overlooked him, like 6'4". And we're like, okay, sorry, buddy, you know, that's kind of the way it goes. His last baseball game at Ada, he was over at Delvis Jefferson. I saw him hit four doubles off the wall. His last basketball game was an all-star game. There weren't too many people from Ada there, but it was a basketball game with all Division I, Division II scholarship basketball players. He put up 25 points, 18 rebounds, you know, 10 assists, got the most valuable player. You know, there's not too many people, and these are all things I'm going to write in Sports Illustrated when they ask me about it, when they do this cover story. Right? So these are all the little anecdotes the head coach gets to say. But, you know, that was one of those things I was just so, it's so privileged for me to get a chance to see all those things. He would have been offered a Division I scholarship in baseball, basketball. I never saw him in hockey except for floor hockey. He was pretty good against the girls in my gym class too at floor hockey. He used to dominate, so he was good there. You know, anybody could get four Division I offers as a high school student, all right? And then when you talk about football, you know, I saw the first game he ever started against Akron in a driving rainstorm, all right? Most people can't even go out and walk their dog in that, and he threw for 400 yards. Me and Jokins were there, and it was amazing. He got a chance to start as a freshman, did fantastic. I saw his very best game at Akron when he set an MAC record of throwing over 500 yards and rushing over 100 yards. I saw last summer when I went to the Denver Broncos camp, I saw him out throw Peyton Manning, who's playing in the Super Bowl. You know? Hey. So, you know, as a football player, he's unmatched around here. And, you know, those are all athletic accomplishments, and it's fantastic. He's getting his jersey retired. But the best thing about Zach Neisser isn't all that stuff. It's the way he's handled all those things. Ever since I met him 10 years ago, I can remember I came in and I told him, I said, Zach, you are the Red Zone Player of the Year. You're going to be in USA Today. It's going to be an article February 6th. He goes, oh yeah, that's cool. He goes, that's my birthday, or close to my birthday. You know, it didn't faze him. He wasn't someone that, you know, wanted records, worried about records. He just played the game. And I don't know where all his buddies are. They know they're all goofy. They all hung out together, and he's still friends with them. You know, he's a great representative of our community. Because of his athletic ability, more because of the kind of person he's a Christian young man. He's extremely respectful. You know, all of Greg's cronies go all those places, and he talks to all of them like he hadn't seen him in a week. You know, and he goes up, hangs out with them, talks to them, goes in. You know, I said, hey, go say some of these girls are okay. He goes up there. Anytime any of these guys ask him for something, he's very good at that. My wife loves to be around him. And the perfect example is what he did when he was a senior in high school for us. You know, against Crestview, he broke his hand, and went back in the game because they said it wouldn't hurt anymore. And all I remember thinking was how crushed I was that I wasn't going to get a coaching minute. I mean, that's the number one thing. I just go, this is my once in a lifetime kid. I'm not going to get a coaching minute anymore. So naturally, he was done. We went in, and Greg went in. They took him to a doctor, great doctor at Lyman. They said, no, he's done. He's a scholarship kid. He's not going to play. And Greg said, we'll find another doctor. All right? So they went around to a couple more, and finally they go, well, we can put a cast on it, and we can play. And so, you know, they put a cast on it. He played with it for the first half of the first game, was fine, and then he just took it off and played. Now, this young man that had his college scholarship, like I said, he's an NFL guy now, but he wanted to play for his high school. He wanted to play with Ronnie and Jay and Nate and Steven, you know, all the guys he grew up with all the time, because he knew how important it was to them and important to him to do that. And it was the greatest run, you know, Ames had in football, those playoff games. You know, if you think back to the Arizona game, we won by a point. You think back to, you know, Arlington game, all those type of things. They were just fantastic. He was the best player in the state. That year, he won the award as the best player in the state of Ohio, but it was all because of the type of young man he was. I know I got a chance to ramble a little bit. I've been waiting 10 years to do this. So it's fantastic. He's a great young man, comes from a great family, and I can't be more prouder than get to introduce this guy and get his number retired here for A to football, A to high school, and the community of Maiden. Zach Neisser. Last thing, when we're wearing Dolphins, because Zach just signed with the Miami Dolphins, and the next 10 years are going to be something we're going to be extremely proud of right here. Congratulations, Zach.